The next topic is of population inversion, and we will do a little mathematical analysis of population inversion. So I have given the introduction of this topic in the previous lectures also, and there we saw that in the case of laser, for a lasing action to achieve lasing action, population inversion is a very mandatory condition that has to be achieved. So for lasing action, population inversion must be achieved in the medium. So firstly, we will revise what is population inversion, and then we will do a little mathematical analysis of this. So firstly, what is population of an energy state? So we are talking about laser. Inside a laser, there are various components of laser that we will discuss. One of those components is the gain medium in which the lasing action occurs. So there is a medium. So in the medium, there are atoms, or you can say molecules, and there are energy states. So there are energy states which are present. So in normal condition, what happens that most of the atoms or molecules, you can say that most of the atoms, they are in the ground state under normal conditions. Most of the atoms, they are in the ground state, because ground state is the most stable one. So in that case, population of lower level is higher as compared to that of the higher energy level. So population of lower energy level is more as compared to that of the excited state. So there are various energy states which are present in the gain medium of the laser. Now, what do we mean by population of an energy state? So by population means that how many number of atoms in unit volume are present in that energy state of the medium. So some of the atoms will be present in the ground state, and very little amount of atoms will be present in the excited state under normal conditions. So by population of an energy state, we mean the number of atoms per unit volume that occupy a given energy state. So that is called as population of that state. So number of atoms, unit volume that are present in that energy state, that is called as population of that state. And we have seen that for the case of laser, population of higher energy level, the population of excited state, must be greater than that of the ground state, or you can say the lower level. So there must be inversion in population. So when number of atoms in the excited state are more than the number of atoms in the lower energy state, so that is called as population inversion, means atoms in the excited state are more as compared to atoms in the lower energy state. And why do we want more population in the excited state? As we have seen in the previous lectures, that the rate of stimulated emission dominates over stimulated absorption only when there is population inversion. So there we saw that the ratio of rate of stimulated emission to that of rate of stimulated absorption, that is equal to N2 divided by N1. So for more rate of stimulated emission, N2 must be greater than N1, and that we have already did in the previous lectures. So N2 must be greater than N1. So number of atoms in the excited state must be more than the number of atoms in the lower energy states. Means the photons are likely to stimulate emission. So photons, they will stimulate the emission than they are absorbed. So the rate of stimulated emission will increase as compared to that of stimulated absorption. So photons, they are likely to, that is, there is more possibility of the photons to stimulate the emission than to be absorbed. So when N2 is higher than N1, that condition is called as population inversion. And why do we call it as population inversion? Because under normal condition, what happens that under normal conditions, the population of lower level is higher. The population of lower level is more as compared to that of excited state, because excited state is unstable as compared to the ground state. So more number of atoms are present in the ground state under normal conditions. But for the case of laser, to have lasing action, for lasing action to occur, the population of higher level, the population of excited state must be greater as compared to the population of ground state. Means we must invert the population. So therefore we call it as population inversion. So it is called so because under normal conditions, number of atoms in the lower energy state, they are more than in the excited energy state. Now we are going to do a little mathematical analysis of population inversion. As we know, according to Boltzmann, so if we have, let's say you have two energy states E1 and E2, and let's say N1 are the number of atoms present in the lower state and N2 are the number of atoms present in the higher state. So according to Boltzmann, number of atoms in any energy state is proportional to e power minus capital E, which is the energy of that particular state, divided by kT. So k is the Boltzmann constant and T is the temperature. So number of atoms in any energy level is directly proportional to e power minus E by kT. So from here you can find out N1. So N1 will be equal to, N1 will be proportional to e power minus E1 by kT, and N2 will be directly proportional to e power minus E2 by kT. So when you will find N2 divided by N1, so N2 divided by N1, so from those expressions when you will find N2 divided by N1, that will be equal to e power minus delta E divided by kT, or you can write it as KBT. So KB stands for Boltzmann constant. So delta E is the difference in energy. So delta E is nothing but equal to E2 minus E1. So when you will solve the expression and you will find the ratio, N2 divided by N1 will be equal to e power minus delta E divided by KBT. And this ratio is termed as Boltzmann ratio. And you can see that this ratio depends upon two factors. So KB is the Boltzmann constant. So this is a universal constant. So this ratio depends upon delta E. So you can change delta E. If you will change the medium, you will change delta E. And also you can change the temperature. So this ratio depends upon delta E and the temperature. So the relative population, this is called as, this ratio is the relative population. So relative population is affected by two main factors. By two factors, one is the energy difference between the two states and the temperature. So now we are going to consider that what happens, that how can we increase the population of the excited state. So in a laser, what do we want? We want more number of atoms in the excited state so that rate of stimulated emission dominates over the rate of stimulated absorption. So we want more stimulated emission. So in that case, we want more number of atoms in the excited state. So more number of atoms must be in the excited state means N2 must be greater than N1. So what do we want? We want this ratio to be greater than 1. So this ratio should be greater than 1. So first case we are considering when delta E is large. So first case we are considering when delta E is large and temperature is small. So what happens in this case? So when delta E is large means the difference in the energy of ground state and the excited state is large and temperature is small. So this is the case we can have in the case of a hydrogen atom. So if we consider hydrogen atom at room temperature. So at room temperature, temperature will be equal to 300 kelvins. And for the case of hydrogen atom, if you find the energy difference between the first and the second level, the delta E will be approximately 10.21 electron volts. So this is the difference in the energy level in the case of hydrogen atom. So from here, for the case of hydrogen atom at room temperature, if you find this ratio N2 divided by N1, so here you can see that delta E is very large. So delta E is large, and if you will find KBT, so if you will find this KBT, it will come out to be very small because temperature, value of temperature is small. So delta E is large as compared to KBT in the first case. So when you will find this ratio N2 divided by N1, it will be approximately equal to, so when you will insert delta E and KBT expression, so N2 divided by N1 will be approximately equal to e power minus 400, and that will approach to 0. So when you will calculate it, N2 divided by N1 will approach to 0, means N2 is very very less than N1 when delta E is large and temperature is small. So in that case, N2 is very very less than N1, or you can say, so N2 are the number of atoms in the excited state and N1 are the atoms in the ground state. So in this case, you can say that all atoms, they are in the ground state. And over here, if you will increase the temperature, so let's say, even if you increase the temperature, so let's say if you increase the temperature to 5000 kelvins, so if you increase the temperature, in that case this ratio will be e power minus 23. It will be approximately e power minus 23, and in that case also you can see that N2 is less than N1. So in this case, when delta E is very very large as compared to the KBT expression, in that case N2 is very very small as compared to N1. So almost there are no atoms in the excited state, all atoms they are in the ground state. But what if you increase the temperature? If you start increasing the temperature, then the number of atoms in the higher, or you can say the excited state, will start increasing. So N2, this N2 will always be less than N1. So if you, even if you will start increasing the temperature, in that case also N2 will be less than N1. So N2 will become non-zero. It will become non-zero, but it will always be less than N1 even if you will increase the temperature, because delta E is very high. The other case we are going to consider is when delta E is small, the difference in the energy levels is small and temperature is very large. So in this case, delta E will be very very less than KBT. So in the earlier case, delta E was very very greater than KBT. In this case, we have the reverse condition. So in this case, N2 by N1. So if delta E is very very small as compared to KBT, delta E is small as compared to KBT, so this will approach to 0. So this expression will approach to 0. So N2 divided by N1 will be approximately e power 0, and that will be equal to 1. So N2 divided by N1 will be equal to 1 when delta E is very small and temperature is very large. So in this case, you can easily see that N2 is equal to N1. So when you have decreased the difference in the energies, when you have lowered the energy difference and you have increased the temperature, in that case N2 will be equal to N1. And even if you will take temperature to infinity, even if the temperature is very very large, in that case also you will have this expression will be equal to 1. So this fraction will be equal to 0 in that case. When temperature approaches to infinity, this expression will be equal to 0 and this whole term will be just equal to 1. So you will have e power 0 and that will be equal to 1. So even if you increase the temperature to a very large value, even in that case also N2 will be equal to N1. So at higher temperatures, the ground state and higher state, they are equally populated. You can see over here that even at higher temperatures, even if you are decreasing the energy and you are increasing the temperature, even in that case also, the ground state and higher state are equally populated. So the ground state and higher state higher energy state are equally populated. So you can clearly see that by increasing the temperature and by decreasing the energy difference, we are able to achieve this condition. When we have large energy difference and smaller temperature, in that case we had the population in excited state was almost negligible as compared to the population in the lower state. Then after decreasing the delta E and increasing the temperature, we were able to get this condition. Means if you will increase the temperature even further, even in that case also N2 will be equal to N1. But in laser, what do we want? In laser, we want N2 to be greater than N1. So by increasing the temperature and by decreasing the delta E, we are not able to achieve the condition of laser. So what do we want? We want population inversion condition to be achieved. So by increasing temperature and decreasing delta E, we are not able to achieve population inversion. In this case, we have N2 is equal to N1. But for laser action to occur, we must have N2 greater than N1. So therefore, by increasing temperature, we cannot achieve population inversion. Though the population of the excited state will be increasing, but as you will increase the temperature further, the population of both these states will become equal. So the number of atoms going to the excited state, the same number of atoms will go to the ground state. So the population of the ground state and the excited state is exactly the same. So to achieve laser action, that is to achieve population inversion, we must find out some other way out. So for laser, we must have population inversion, but by these processes, we are not able to achieve population inversion. So there must be other techniques. We must follow some other techniques to achieve population inversion. So the condition of population inversion can be achieved by supplying external energy. So we supply the medium, the gain medium of the laser is supplied with external energy. So external energy is supplied to the medium, and this process of supplying external energy to the gain medium of the laser so as to achieve population inversion is called as pumping. So this method in which we increase the population of the excited state, in which we achieve population inversion in the medium by supplying external energy, it can be in the form of photons or it can be in the form of electrical energy. So it can be in So there are various methods of supplying energy and increasing the population inversion. So this method of supplying the external energy to the system is called as pumping or excitation. So it is also called as excitation. So we achieve population inversion in the case of laser using the various pumping techniques. So we use pumping process to achieve population inversion, and in the upcoming lectures we will see that what are the various techniques that come under the pumping process. So there are various techniques by which we can increase the population of the excited state. So that will come under the types of pumping techniques.